Students, here we are going to study about strings in Java. Okay, first of all we are going to see what is called as a string and what is called as a character. So a string is a sequence of characters. Characters means letters, alphabets. That is a sequence of characters. In Java, this sequence or group of characters is enclosed within double quotes. For example, computer. Computer is enclosed within double quote, is a valid string constant, and just C. Okay, the character that is enclosed in single quote is a valid character constant. In Java, string constants are enclosed within double quotes and character constants are enclosed within single quotes. Okay. Next one is, we are going to see the example of a string and the syntax, how to write the strings in Java. For example, in Java, if we need to store a string constant, that is computer, for example, using a variable of the string class, you can write it in the form string s is equal to computer. Here s is the variable of the string class that is assigned the value computer. Every character of the sequence of characters that are stored in the variable s is represented by its index or position. The index or positions of the first character in a string is always 0. Okay. So, in a string computer, the position of C is 0 and O is 1, M is 2, like this it will go. Okay, the index is always called as a address. And the next character is 1 and then the next character is 2 and so on. The following illustration shows the index or positions of the characters in the string variable S. So, the string S consisting of string computer. The characters C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R. So the index or the positions of these characters are starting from 0. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this it will go. Okay students. Now a string is a class that is defined in the Java language package. String constants are enclosed within double quotes. Then string length. How to find out the length of the string? So the length of the string means it will count the number of characters that is present in the string and display the output. The length of a string is the number of characters contained in it. The length of method can be used to obtain it. The following example illustrated. String x is equal to computers. So the length of the string is equal to s dot length of. So system dot out dot print of length. Okay. The length of method of the string class returns the number of characters present in the string. The next one is concatenation. Concatenation means joining of two strings together. Okay. Joining of more than one string together is called concatenation. You can already see a bit of concatenation being done with plus in the system.out.print method. The concatenation of strings can also be done in string variables. For example, if there are three strings, that is S1, S2 and S3. So S1 we are going to store some strings and S2 we are going to store some strings and S3 we are going to store the sum of the first string and the second string. Okay. So the value of S3 is the first string and the second string. Okay students. So the output will be first string, second string. Okay. Next we are going to see the join. Okay, the function used to join these two strings are called concatof. Okay, join of two strings is called concatenation. You can either use the plus operator to join two strings or to use the concatof method to join two strings. Okay, the next one is you can concatenate a value of any data type with a string. The resultant is always a string. Okay. So if the data type is different, then the output is always string data type. Okay students. Then character data type. A character data type is used to represent a single character. A string is a group of characters. A character literal is always enclosed within a single quote. For example, character x is equal to a. Notice the declaration of the variable x, which has been initialized with a single character a. Since Java follows the Unicode system of representing characters in the memory, it occupies 2 bytes of memory space. It is possible to represent 65,536 characters in Java. The next one is, we are going to see the tables which shows the different Unicodes for capital letters, small letters and digits. Okay. So the character capital A to Z, the Unicode is from 65 to 90. Small a to z, the Unicode is from 97 to 122. For the character 0 to 9, we have to use the Unicode 48 to 57. Okay, so the character constant that consisting of a single character enclosed within single quote. You can use relational operators for comparison of the characters also. Next, we are going to see what is the difference between the character and the string. Characters, when passed to the method called dialog of BlueJ, should enclosed within single quote. String should be enclosed within double quote. So when you are using the functions, when you are writing the program by using the function, you have to give the value during the time of execution like this. Okay, if it is a character constant, in this arrow you are seeing here you have to write the characters between the single quote. Okay, you can increment or decrement a character to get the character before or after it. The next one is equalization of strings. So for finding the equalization of strings, we are using the function equals of. Okay, so equalization of strings, the equals of methods compare characters in a string and check whether the two strings are equal or not. If the two strings matches, it returns a true, and if it does not match, it returns a false. Okay, the following example will illustrate this. So the string S1 is computer, string S2 is computer. So if E1 equals if S1 equals S2, so if both are equal and the cases also equal, means the characters uppercase or lowercase, capital letter or small letter are equal, then it will display that it is equal. Otherwise, it will display not equal. Okay, here the characters are same, so it will display equal. This is because the both strings S1 and S2 are equal. Okay, now we are going to see the equals of versus double equaled. Double equaled means comparison. Okay, so the equals of and the double equal operator perform two different operations I've just explained. The equals of method compares the characters inside a string object. Okay, the double equal to operator compares two objects' references to see whether they refer to the same instance or not. So one programming example is here, that is string S1 equal to hello. Okay, string S2 equal to new string of S1. So here we have created the object for the string S1, and we are going to compare this third string, that is in the third string we are going to store the first string. Okay, now the condition is like this: S1 dot equals to S2. S1 and S2 are equal to yes. Okay, that is the object of the first string. Then S1 equal to S2, that is false. It may be different or same. Then S1 dot S3, S1 dot equals of S3, yes, it is true. Then S1 equal to S3, yes, because the value stored in S3 is same as that of the value S1. So the answer is, the output is true. Next, the Equal ignore case of function is used to check for equality between two strings ignoring the case. Then changing the case of a characters within a string. Two methods are available in Java to change the case of a character. The method to lowercase of converts all the characters in the string from uppercase to lowercase. The to uppercase of method converts all the characters in a string from lowercase to uppercase. So non-alphabetical characters such as digits are unaffected. The following program will illustrate the use of these methods. So first of all, string s1 equal to computer, that is upper and lower. Okay, the upper, so we are using the variables s1, upper, lower. Upper equal to s1 dot to uppercase of. We are going to convert the string s1 into uppercase. So all the letters are in capital letters, so it is capital equal to computer. Okay, then next one is lower equal to s1 dot to lowercase of. So we are converting all the characters in the lowercase, so we have to write all the letters in lowercase, that is computer. Okay, the next one is the to uppercase of method is used to convert all characters in a string to capital letters. The to lowercase of method is used to convert all characters in a string to small letters. Okay, students. Now, searching strings. Here we are using we are going to find out the position of that string. Here we are using two functions, that is index of and lost index of. Okay, so the index of and lost index of methods can be used to search for a substring or a character. The index of searches for the first occurrence of the characters or substring, and the lost index of search for a lost occurrence of the characters or substring. Both these functions return the index position at which the character or substring is found. If a character or substring is not found, it returns 1. Okay. So, for example, string s is equal to Siliguri. So, system.out.println of s.index of I. So, we have to write the index of I in the starting position. So, it is 0, 1, 1. Its position is 1. So if you write like this, s dot index of I comma 2, so the second time I where is coming, it will write the index of that I, that is 0 1 2 3. The answer is 3. Okay, so how this, how the index of and last index of functions will work. Now we are going to see the tabular column of all the functions that we are using in a string. That is, length of this function is used to find the length of the string. Character at of I, we are going to find out which character is present in a particular position. Then substring of is e means we are going to find out the part of a string. Then substring of s means substring of s is extract the character from s till the end of the string. Now the next function is index of c. We are going to find out the address of the character c. Index of c comma p means we are going to find out the index of search for the character c or string from the position p onwards and return its index. In case it is unable to find, it returns 1. Next one is lost index of C. It is used to search for the character C or the string S from the right to left. Next one is to uppercase of. We are going to convert the string to uppercase. To lowercase of means we are going to convert the string to lowercase. Replace C comma D means we are going to replace the letter C with D. A dot equals of B means if there are two strings are there, we are going to see whether the string A and B are equal. A dot equal ignore case of B means we are going to ignore the case of the letter B. Okay, ignore the case, but the letter should be same. A dot starts with B means it checks whether the string begins with the string B or not. The next one is A dot ends with B. It checks whether the string ends with the string B or not. Then trim off, it removes all leading and trailing spaces. Okay. Then A dot compare to, it is used to lexicographically checks two strings whether the Unicode differs. Okay, students. So these all about the lesson strings. You have to learn all the functions carefully. Okay, students.